Hello and welcome everyone. So in this video we will take a look on another example to define the associations, how we can define the associations between the multiple tables. So let's quickly go there. Okay, so this is a shopping cart type application we are building. So we have order, customer, product, payment. So let's try to identify the relationships here. Order will have, what do you say, the products. So there is a one-to-many relationship between the order and product, okay? Then customer will have order, right? So customer will have order, or order belongs to customer. Customer will have a multiple order. Order will have a multiple products. Product will belong to order, and payment will belong to order, right? Because if there is a one order, then there is a one-to-one mapping with the order and payment, order and customer. Customer can have multiple order, but order will belongs to a one single customer only. So order has one customer. Customer has many orders. Order has many product, right? And order has one payment, or order belong to payment. These all definitions we can find out, like order belongs to customer, order has many product, product belongs to, I mean, product, like there are multiple products, right? Product can belong to multiple orders, right? So payment has one order. I mean, this is a one-to-one relationship between the payment. Order will have only single payment, and customer has many orders. You can have multiple orders. So these are the theoretical representations. So first we will divide it into two sections. First we will talk about customer and order only, like order belongs to a customer, or customer has many orders, or you can say, right, customer has many orders, or order belong to a customer. This we will try to first identify from the code. So what we will do is we will drop the existing table. See this step 3 or 4. Sequelize db drop, and let's go to the section for that. Okay, here we have already done Sequelize init. We have the migration seeders and models folder. So here we will just talk about two models, one customer, one order. So order belongs to a customer. This is the only relationship we have, or you can say customer has many orders. Order belongs to a customer. So what this line will do, this line will create one order ID, I mean one customer ID in the order collection, right? And this index.js is the default file. Now when we talk about migrations, how it runs, there is order, right? Order is a simple table which has the ID, order, name, order, description. Customer is the ID and name and email, that's it. Now when we define the associations between them, let's we have index.js also, server.js here, Sequelize force false. So I will just say node server.js. So what is happening right now, I think table doesn't exist, right? So we need to create the first table. Sequelize db create. So it will create the database. Sequelize db migrate. So it will just migrate the database. Now we can also see it if we have anything. No seeder found, right? But you can put a seeders here, or you can create the seeder and you can run that. Okay, so this is how we run the migrations. Now associations are important part here, how we can define the association between the customer and the order, right? So in the models, first of all, we already said that this is how we define the associations. We already aware orders don't belong to a customer. Now same thing, we need to define that in the migrations to create associations, primary key, foreign key, right? So what we are doing here, orders will have a customer ID, which will be, customer ID will be a part of customer's table as a primary key, and customer ID will be a foreign key in the orders table to represent that. In the down, you just remove that customer ID from the orders table, that's it. So it has up and down feature. And when we are running this db migrate, because we already executed migration, so there are no migrations, but we can just sequelize db drop. We can just try these few assumptions. Db drop, db create, and db migrate. So migrations will run the migrations, and in the database you can see we have these two tables. Customers will have this information, order will have a customer ID. Right now in the server.js you can just write your own query, how like you wanted to get the customers, then model dot customer, I think it's customer only, model dot customers. So in server.js, model.customer.findAll, it will give you all the customers. Okay, this is all about this first video. And the second video will talk more about the other relationships.